First off, it's in the key of E, so that means it's probably not open D. So is it open E, maybe? Well, he's doing... during that one, during a couple verses, right? But if you were tuned to open E, this note would already be tuned to G sharp, so you couldn't hammer it on like that, right there. So... That's kind of the clue. And then it also has Keith's patented, which he does in a lot of his acoustic blues. This one, I guess, is sort of Appalachian, but that's another clue that it's A to A7 in standard tune. So it sounds to me like in the first, oh, help me. E, and then set. Regular E, then 7 it with the B string at the 3rd fret, and then back off again. A to A7. So that's just a regular A, then the high E of 5, then down to 3. Most Keith acoustic tunes that have an A in it, when he's playing standard, he does this. So that's A and A7. Back. Now that last one doesn't sound like your typical A, E to B7. Back. Almost sounds like E to A, then off on the B string. But I think it's actually this as I listen to it. Now that they've got the remasters on it, you can really hear it. So it's a B7, except instead of covering the high E at the 2nd fret, you cover the B at the 2nd fret, and then off. So then it's just those 3 fingers, and then back to E. And then after a couple of verses, it sounds like instead of that, he starts doing... It's just hammering the G string at the 1st fret. Just take a D7 shape, so move it up. It starts with E7. Up a fret, up another, and then you're at A. That one I can hear him doing, hammering on the G string up, just like he did here. Except now you're doing it up here. Just take an F shape all the way up to A at the 5th fret. Then up to D. He just does a little lick there. He's not doing to D or up to D. He just kind of fiddles around with it on the D. At least it sounds like it. G, D. And so that one, I do it as a D. A D with the E, the high E open. Like on one of those last couple of verses, instead of doing this, he's doing the same thing as he did here, except he's doing it in A. It's making it a 7 by doing the B string 3 frets up from where you bar here. I think the last thing is. So it starts with a A7 up here, just a D7 shape brought all the way up to A7. So then on that last one, instead of bringing the whole thing up, it sounds like the B stays where it is. So G and high E at 12, and B stays at 10. And it just sort of ends right there. Evaporates on that, whatever that chord is. That's how I'm playing it. Good luck.